Hi guys, my topic for today is micropropagation. I believe by the end of this video, you'll have a better understanding on what is micropropagation and plant tissue culture is all about. I would begin with how did it start. In 1902, a German botanist by the name of Gottlieb Herbeland was the first to grow isolated plant cells on an artificial medium. This is where the field started progressing and the field of tissue culture has been spectacular now. So, what do we know about tissue culture? Plant tissue culture is important discovery in terms of cells and the studies which refers to the isolation of cells, tissues or organs from a plant and growing them aseptically in a suitable containers on normally artificial nutrient medium under a controlled condition. Plant tissue culture is widely used to produce clones of plant in a method known as micropropagation. Micropropagation can be commercially applicable to produce nursery plants and fresh flowers. Thousands of plants can be rapidly produced from a single plant using this technique. This culture technique can be used to produce pathogen-free plants without going through the slow conventional breeding method. The methodology for this micropropagation method begins with media preparation, followed by initiation, and lastly the hardening of plantlet and its establishment. In preparing the medium, the Murashige and Scoop medium, which is also well known as the MS medium, is used. Other important media formulation is the Gambock B5, which is also included. To prepare a half MS medium, 5 ml of each of the MS macronutrient, namely ammonium nitrate, potassium nitrate, calcium chloride, magnesium sulfate, and monopotassium phosphate was added into the plastic beaker. Another 0.5 ml of micronutrient containing boric acid, manganese sulfate, zinc sulfate, potassium iodide, sodium molybdate, copper disulfate, and cobalt chloride was also added. The next 0.5 ml of B5 vitamins added, followed by the addition of 2 g of sucrose. Lastly, 50 ml of distilled water was added into the beaker and the pH was adjusted to 5.8. After adjusting the pH, the volume was brought up to 100 ml. About 0.9% of agar was added and the beaker was placed in microwave to melt all the agar. Finally, the medium was poured into a 2 bottles and sent for autoclave for 15 minutes. Next is to do the surface sterilization. To create an aseptic condition for the culture, cleanliness and sterilization is very important. The laminar flow where the inoculation will later take place is normally swept with alcohol before used. All the other materials will be sprayed with 70% of ethanol before transferring them into the laminar hood chamber. A Bunsen burner will be used for sterilizing inoculation loop, petri dish lips, and so on. The surface sterilization begins with decanting the water from the seeds, then adding a 95% of ethanol to the seeds. The seeds will be then soaked for 2 minutes by shaking the append of tubes. The ethanol was later decanted, and 1 ml of 20% of Clorox bleach and 1 drop of 20 is later added and the seeds will be soaked for 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, the seeds will be rinsed at least for 5 times with the distilled water just to ensure the seeds are really clean and there's no any detergents left over. After letting the seeds to dry for a few minutes, 3 seeds from the seeds was inoculated into the bottle containing half MSO. This procedure is repeated for a second bottle of half MSO as well. after inoculation, the bottle will be sterilized with the fire from the Bunsen burner and cover the bottle and keep it under the light for 16 hours and 8 hours in the dark. This allows the germinations to take place. The germination rate for the seeds will be later observed for the upcoming next 4 weeks. The last part of micropropagation is the establishment of plants in the soil, which is also known as hardening. A 3-month-old plantlet was removed from the bottle carefully, which is then cleaned and washed with the tap water. This is to ensure that all the attached media is removed. After that, the plantlet will be transferred to a flower plot which contains soil. Preparation was made on a clear plastic bag. This is mainly to improve the air circulation and also to maintain the 100% humidity for the plant. There is a few ethical issues can be discussed related to micropropagation. First of all, effects on the environment, herbicide use and resistant effects on the environment are a particular concern with regard to the GMO crops and food production. Although the pesticide use can protect the crop against unwanted insects, they can also have an unintentional effect on a neutral or even beneficial species. Not only that, besides that, it concerns have been raised regarding adverse effect on a monarch butterfly population, which is actually not the original target of the pesticide. Moreover, the crops of Roundup ready soybeans have already been implemented into the agriculture practices, possibly conferring the Roundup resistance to the neighboring plants. Plant tissue culture represent the most promising areas of application at present time. The main advantage of tissue culture technology lies in the production of high quality and uniform planting material that can be multiplied on a year-round basis under a disease-free condition and also supplied anywhere irrespective of season and weather. Through this, a long-term agriculture and forestry can be sustainable. Moreover, Compared to the other methods of propagation, micropropagation systems are cheaper in terms of production of large numbers of new plants. It can also increase the production by 100% compared to all the other cloning methods. Thus, more farmers can eventually venture into this business. Through that, it can also increase the food production, whereby through the increase of food production, the supply will be able to meet the demand. Moreover, nurseries and flower industries can also reap great rewards. For an example, orchid propagation, which is actually a big business and specialty ornament for the decoration. Micropropagation can also be used to generate endangered plants, which from there we can preserve all the endangered plants. Moreover, bioremediation to remove the pollution and heavy metals can also be done through micropropagation. Thus, all these opportunities can open a gate for other industries to also play a role in plant tissue culture.